time for Here's an Idea. And we begin with football free agency, and here's an idea. The Jets should sign Richard Sherman, or at least find out what it would take to sign him. Moose, I don't know about this idea, okay? Richard Sherman, we all know, I mean, all pro, shutdown corner for years, but coming off a torn Achilles, 1 year left on his contract, the Seahawks reportedly released him today. Would he fit in well with the Jets? I think a healthy Richard Sherman,
yeah,
absolutely. But you're not dealing with a healthy Richard Sherman here. He's going to be recovering from injury, and I like where the Jets' secondary is right now. Do they need more? Yes, they do. But I would rather get a younger player and build the secondary. If Sherman comes in, very strong personality. Look, he's a winner, no doubt about it, but you're not getting Richard Sherman at 100%. So for an idea, I don't think it's a good one.
Yeah, I don't think it's a good idea either, John. I think you nailed it. What am I paying Richard Sherman for? Am I paying him for what he is or what he was, right? I'm paying him more so probably for what he was with the Seattle Seahawks at the peak of his career. He was an absolute shutdown corner. You mentioned it, coming off the ruptured Achilles tendon. He's logged a lot of years. Is he at his peak, at his best right now? I get you've got a lot of money to spend, but it's up to Mike Maccagnan to spend that money wisely. And I respect everything that Richard Sherman has accomplished. However, if I'm looking for a solution at the cornerback spot, I'm not looking to invest in Richard Sherman. I think he's a good guy. I think he's a leader. I think he could fit someplace else if I don't have to lean on him all that much. But I am not willing. The risk reward to me for the Jets doesn't make all that much sense.
The one thing that makes me interested, though, is he's going to have a chip on his shoulder. And
that's
Sherman's
true.
The kind of guy motivated like that, as he said, smart guy, leader. I could see that being helpful, but he's got to be on the field and he's got to be 100%.
Okay, John, here's another idea. Do not overreact to Jacob deGrom's first spring training start on Sunday. I agree. Why overreact? I mean, honestly, we get into it, right? And we do this on a daily basis here on Loud Mouths on SNY. What did this guy do up at the plate? Steven Matz, last two starts leading into today's start. How has Zach Wheeler responded since the acquisition of Jason Vargas? Listen, for deGrom, the fact that he's toeing the rubber, he's over a little bit of that back soreness. That's really all I care about, is that when he makes that start, he comes out of it healthy. Whether he's effective, not effective, I don't care, because I think Jacob deGrom has enough of a track record as a regular season starter to believe however he looks over the weekend, it really does not matter.
I'm with you, Moose. I don't think you overreact here. It's all about the back, the lower back. That's what we've been hearing about. If he goes out there, throws three innings, even if he gets shelled by whoever he's facing, if he gets out of it healthy and feeling okay, that's what you take from this. If he throws three perfect innings, that's great too.
Right.
But you can't lean one way or another. And it's tough because you watch these spring training games. We talked about Matz at the beginning of this show. You want to immediately react and say, hey, this guy's ready, or this guy needs to be sent down. With Jacob deGrom, we know what he can do, provided he's 100% ready to go.
Well, and as long as he's 100% and comes out of it 100% and feeling good, and all signs right now and all systems look like they're on go, John, that's all you're looking for.
Yeah, they need a healthy deGrom.
No question.
All right, we close this with this idea. In honor of the 21st anniversary of Biggie Small's death, Moose, I'll ask you first. What was your favorite Notorious B.I.G. song?
Yeah, Hypnotize is my favorite one. Life After Death album. I think that is the one that really gets you going. There's a lot that you can choose from. An absolute legend in the industry. There's no question about it. Taken from us way too soon. I can't believe it's been 21 years. But Hypnotize would top the list.
It's an excellent choice. I mean, Artie Lang, I used to work with, would sing Give Me the Loot all the time.
Oh, fantastic.
That's a great one. Money, More Problems, of course. But Juicy is the one I'm going to go with. Juicy helped put him on the map, I think. And, you know, now I'm in the limelight because I rhyme tight. And then, of course, you've got Big Papa, which I also like a lot, you know, because, Moose, I love it when you call me Big Papa.
Do you really?
No, I just
I didn't know we were that close.
I just like saying the lyric. We got matching pink shirts. Come on.
We do. I understand.
Today's
I thought that was you and I thing. I didn't think that was for everyone else.
Oh, well, we're still on.